Hey everyone, Patrick CK here with episode 9 of 3D printing with a Monoprice printer. It's been some time since episode 8, and needless to say, a few things have changed that will impact the future of the series, hopefully for the better. If you haven't been keeping up with the recent developments or are new to the channel, I've switched both the software I use to create 3D models and the printer I use to print those models. Originally, we were using the desktop version of Trimble's SketchUp to make our 3D models, but recent changes to both SketchUp and other modeling software, I've made the move to use Blender for everything 3D CAD. If you've never used Blender, and specifically if you're a SketchUp user, I have an ongoing series teaching beginners how to use Blender. The series focuses on the transition from SketchUp to Blender, going over their similarities, but more often their differences, and how to overcome ingrained habits to learn this new powerful tool. I'll leave a link to the first episode of that series in a card and the description. The next big change is the namesake of this series. While I still have and use the Monoprice Maker Select V2, due to a series of events, I picked up a new-ish printer. The Maker Pro 10 Mini is still a Monoprice product, but let's say it's a few steps ahead of the V2, and is now my go-to printer. If you haven't seen my review and first impressions of the MP10, I'll leave a link to part 1 of that mini series in the card and the description. With all of the changes out of the way, let's get into what this episode is about. The switch to using Blender brings up a few changes to the workflow. For the better. Right away, simply saving 3D models for printing in Blender is easier since exporting to STL, the most common 3D file extension, is built into Blender and doesn't require an extension or plugin like it did with SketchUp. And as mentioned in another episode, with SketchUp's transition to being online only, exporting to STL is practically impossible. So Blender is the way to go. Here we have a simple model I made for some shelving units I bought recently. I had a couple vertical supports left over, which needs these end caps to secure the top shelves in place. Exporting to STL is extremely simple. Go up to File, go down to Export, and select STL from the export list. In the export window, give it a name and click Export. There are a few things to remember when creating models in Blender that will be exported for 3D printing. I'll go over those details in the next episode, so make sure to subscribe so that you don't miss out on that when it's published. Now you have your model in the STL format, which we can use to import into our slicing program. I am still using Cura to slice up and save our models into the G-code standard to use in 3D printing. Of course, since episode 8, I have updated Cura to 4.10, which has an improved interface and some quality of life improvements all around. I did run into one problem in Cura, and that is the lack of a profile for the MP10 Mini. For some reason, only version 4.0 had a profile for the MP10, which didn't get carried over to future versions of Cura. I have no idea why this is the case. It seems a little weird that it would be included in one version and not in the subsequent versions. Fortunately, it's fairly easy to add the MP10 to the printer list in Cura. The fastest way to add any new printer is to click the default printer name here next to the open file icon. Then select Add Printer. Under Add a non-network printer, scroll down until you see the list item called Custom and select it. Under this option, select Custom FFF Printer. Then in the right column, give the printer a name and click Add. In the Machine Settings screen that pops up next, enter the values for your printer. Here are the settings for the MP10 Mini. Most of these values you'll know just by reviewing the spec sheet, but the two sections at the bottom of the printer tab called Start G-code and End G-code will need some more explanation. These two pieces of code run before and after every print, respectively. This code contains instructions such as move nozzle to home position, extrude filament, cool down bed, etc. The default values should be fine, but if you'd like the factory spec code, I'll have it available on my site at the link in the description to easily copy and paste at your leisure, along with all the other values you'll need to set up the MP10 Mini. As a note, if you haven't seen the MP10 Mini review video, the only difference between the regular MP10 and the Mini is the height of the Z-axis. 400mm or 15.75 inches for the regular MP10 and 200mm or 7.87 inches for the Mini. All the other values are the same for both printers. From here, the rest of the process is the same as before. Select slice, review the results, even play the path that the printhead will take printing each layer. This is a really cool feature. After spending an inordinate amount of time watching the print preview, you can save your print-ready G-code file. After a short print, we have our new piece, and watch it fit perfectly into the support. It's a beautiful thing. I doubt I'll ever get tired of being able to print my own components, especially when they are this useful. Anyway, this is the workflow I've been following for the last few months. If you have any suggestions or questions, don't hesitate to leave a comment below or reach out to me on my website. That's it for this episode. I hope it's been helpful. If it has, please leave a like and share so others can find this content in the future. Until next time, this has been Patrick CK. Goodbye.